Angela says, Jeff, nice shirt. I'm not trying to be fresh, but that's my favorite shirt of yours.
Angela, you can be fresh with me anytime, baby. All right. All right. I can
use some, not on IG.
I can use some fresh. All right. Just don't send me shit on Instagram, ladies, because she sees it. Right? But yeah. All right, here we go. Camera's working. Camera's working. We're live.
Woo!
Just did it. So if you checked our Instagram stories, which you might not have done, literally I set up 15 minutes before the show. Test do an equipment check. I got lighting, and I got obviously no hair and makeup. Hello, look at me. We got a microphone. I got an external camera right there, and the camera didn't work. I'm like, why is not the camera not working? I'm switching sides, switching around. And then Joelle comes in. She looks down and she noticed the tiny little tear. She's like, is your wire ripped? I look down there, fucking little teeth mark, which belonged to a cat, not a dog.
It was more than a teeth mark. They like
went to town. It was not a dog. A dog would have fucking shredded it. I got three fucking dogs next to me here. And a cat comes down in here during the day. It chewed right through my electrical cord. So I had to strip down the cords. There's a positive and negative. Splice them together. Make sure that they were electrical tape there. Put them all back together again. Plug it in. Didn't get shocked. And I'm here. So we got video, man. We're fucking hot tonight. Hey, everybody. How are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is the What Would Jeff Do Dog Training Show. This is
break a sweat?
Oof, this is Joelle next to me. I didn't break a sweat at all. This is Joelle next to me. She's one of my trainers at the training center. She also does the social media. She also travels with me on the road. Linda is going to be doing the shows on Monday night. If you're brand new to my world, Linda's my wife. And if you look at Monday night show, she's the one that was on Monday night. What's today? What day of the week is today?
Saturday.
Today's Saturday night. I think she's on Monday. No, she did Monday night. All right. So the way this works is this. It's a Q&A show. You ask me a question, I give you an answer. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and I've got a training center up in Providence, Rhode Island, and we specialize in aggression rehab and behavior modification. We're really, really good at stopping unwanted behaviors. That's my level of expertise. Obviously, we can deal with some young puppies and some easier dogs. Obviously, we train all the basic obedience commands on leash and off leash. But what our real expertise is stopping things you don't want. We deal with extreme aggression, dog aggression, extreme human aggression, massive amounts of anxiety, crate behavior, a lot of stuff. So a lot of my questions on this show are going to be, Jeff, how do you stop? How do you stop? How do you stop? You can hear me talk about the word punishment a lot. The word punishment is, you don't need to yell and scream at your dog. I agree. We don't yell. We don't scream. Punishment is not about that, but that's the only way to stop unwanted behavior. Ironically, on the flip side, 90% of our day at the training center is reward-based. We're food trainers. We use clickers, all right? We use the word yes. We reward dogs all day long. That's how we train dogs, how we want to do something. You have to do that thousands of times, by the way. But a proper punisher, usually you have to do once if it's a proper punisher. So we utilize almost every tool in the toolbox. We don't shy away from that. I don't give a shit about public opinion or what people think. I don't get into discussions about science because it's all a bunch of bullshit and lies and hocus pocus and an ideology that's destined for your dog to die. And I'm blunt as hell. And if I also swear, so if you've got young children in there, I say fuck a lot because I can't help it because I'm passionate about this stuff because I actually truly care about humans. I'm more human-centric than dog-centric. Of course I care about dogs, but humans are the ones in pain. And I'm here to eliminate your pain with really straightforward answers. And if you're brand new and if this is too much for you, that's fine. If you want to sit through it, sit through it. If you don't, tune off. But if you're struggling with your dog with behaviors that are relatively simple, like jumping and resource guarding and pulling on a walk and growling, simple things to fix. It shouldn't take you more than a couple of days, at a maximum a week to stop it. So we stop resource guarding in 3 seconds, jumping in 3 seconds, getting in the litter box in 3 seconds, trying to jump over a fence in 3 seconds. All that stuff is really, really quick. All right. So here we go. Oh, there's a little dollar sign at the bottom. Dollar, dollar, make you holla. And what you can do is we don't get through all the questions usually. So if you do a super chat, and you throw us some cash, You don't have to. I'm still going to get to your question the best I can, but they do go in order. I do talk a lot. I like to tell stories. I like to chit chat. Most of these questions actually need probably a 5-week boarding train. Maybe, maybe not, but they, you know, I'm a big advocate. I'm training the whole dog. Proper exercise, proper diet, train what you want, eliminate what you don't want, not Band-Aid, but my show is sort of Band-Aid approach. But we use that money to go out for dinner, my wife and I. So we went out for dinner to, where did we go this week? Cheesecake Factory? Was that Monday night?
How would I know?
Because you
went for dinner.
Because you watched my Instagram stories. That's why.
I have no idea.
We went to Cheesecake Factory and I ate healthy. And then last night we took out Sandy and Chris to Los Andes. Now that's going to take about a month worth of super chats to pay off. But we went there and it was fantastic. So here we go. Doug H.
Well, actually, we have $2 from Tony Cash. He says, your photos are too straight.
Tony, that's because David. I'm trying to give him a night off. Next.
Doug H. Can you explain again why dog parks are best left alone?
Sure. I've said this hundreds of times, Doug. I know you've heard it before, but I'll tell it to you again. They're the most dangerous, disgusting places to ever take your dog. They're riddled with disease. They're riddled with dogs that you don't know their behavior. They're with dogs that are there that are aggressive, pushy, snotty. You can't say boo to the dog, let alone correct the dog, and you're setting your dog up for failure. I would never take my dogs to a dog park. Next.
Beth L., any seminar dates in Texas this coming year? Thank you so much for all the amazing content you put out. It's been such a valuable resource for me.
Yes, we'll do Texas. Normally, I'm in Texas right now, by the way. So the last 2 months of my tour, I had to cancel. I have to stay in Providence. So, but normally in November/December, I'm in Texas. I'll be back in Texas. Again, we got a private client in Texas
in January,
that's a private client right outside of Austin, but I'll be in Texas soon. Next.
Lori, have a newly adopted Pipple Chow who is 7 years old, who shows a great deal of dominance. How do I stop this? He gets up on you. When you try to get him down, he barks and throws a fit. He also does a lot of mouthing.
Okay, so you've got a snot of a dog. You own a snot of a dog. So what I want you to do is I want you to try to unsnot the dog. Number one, everyone should be doing this. Is your dog crated at night? It should be. Crated when you're not home? It should be. Off the furniture, off the bed. Everything is permission-based. Where's your dog right now? You're watching my show. Your dog should be on a dog bed, 3 feet to 5 feet away from you, lying down, not moving. Your dog should not be walking around the house. Your dog should have a leash on if it's not underneath voice control. You need to learn to apply a proper punisher to your dog. Okay, the mouthing stuff will not go away until the dog is dead, and then it'll stop mouthing you unless it happens to have a heart attack with its mouth on your arm, and then it'll be forever there on your arm. Take that one to the vet. Then what I want you to do is figure out what your proper punisher is. Train your dog. First, be proactive. Train your dog obedience. Place. Go lie down on a bed. Lie down. Down anywhere I say. Walk next to me. No nonsense anymore. No unwanted barking. No snottiness. Nothing. Get yourself a bonker. A bonker is a towel. It's a wrapped up towel. There's nothing in between. It's a piece of cotton wrapped up, rolled up. You would say no. Boom. Hit your dog on the top of the head. Yeah, I'm telling people to hit their dogs with towels. You have to figure out what a punisher is. All right. The bottom line is you'll be struggling with this for the next 5 years. You're brand new to my world. Dive deep inside of my 5,000 videos. Next.
Chevy, yes, listening to you while painting. What's your opinion on the side submit and using natural techniques like staring, heel tap, side poke to show leadership to a stubborn, bratty dog?
I've never turned a dog on its side other than to cut its nails, and that's just out of convenience. Sometimes at the vet, we've got to put them on their side, but I would never use this. I don't side submit a dog. I will never side submit a dog, and I don't recommend anybody side submit a dog. I think it's a very dangerous thing to do, especially when a dog's in drive. It's the easiest way to get bit. It doesn't show shit to the dog, in my opinion. Okay? As far as natural, what the fuck does natural mean? Throw gear shit at the dog? I mean, what do you mean natural? Rub two sticks together and touch them to their feet? Come on, Chevy, you're in New Zealand, get out of the woods. What I want you to do is utilize modern tools like remote collars. But yes, I'm a huge advocate of using, you can do a little boom like that. You can do a heel tap. I have no problem with that at all. But a lot of people can't do that. So that's why we like our training tools. Next.
Tammy, dog only has separation anxiety when another person takes the leash. Working with trainer. Trainer takes her and she loses it, even if she's only a few feet away. How to manage or correct? Been using your techniques for over 1 year. Great progress with my fearful, reactive dog. Thank you.
Tammy, you're asking the wrong person. Ask the trainer that has the leash. And I'm being serious. Hopefully you're not paying for this. And don't tell me who the trainer is because I don't want to know. But the trainer has the leash. That's when the problem starts. Okay, trainer, fix the problem. Right? I mean, I'm not trying to be a dick here, but it's like, what are you paying for? Like, they should fix the problem. What are you going to do? Go to the next session and say, well, Jeff says do this. Here, let's watch Jeff's video. I'll interpret so you, who I'm giving money, you can do it. No. So seriously, the trainer should help you. What I want you to do is hold the trainer accountable. I'll be back on Monday night, if you don't hate me already, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Monday night. I'll be back. Let me know how it goes. Next. And I'm not trying to avoid your question. I'm just like, you're working with a trainer. I don't, you know. Go, next.
Monoxide. My six-month-old Roddy lashed out a couple times with my wife when she pet her. Not full aggression, but enough to correct. Should I be concerned when correcting with e-collar while my wife is close to her?
You should be concerned about a six-month-old Roddy lashing out. But this is the thing. A lot of people misinterpret dog signals. I'm not going to say the dog didn't lash out with intent to harm. I'm not going to say that. But I've seen dogs go into play bows and owners say, oh my God, my dog's about to fight. It's like, no, that's a play bow. You know what I mean? I've seen dogs do a lot of things that were playful, that were people interpreted that were dangerous, and vice versa. Things that were dangerous that people were like, oh, isn't that cute? I'm like, cute. Your dog's about to bite that kid in 3, 2, 1 lunge. You better be holding on. So the bottom line is this. What kind of affection are you giving your six-month-old lunging Roddy? You should be close to none right now. Guys, if affection fixed dogs, I would be giving affection all day long. I would invest in infection.com. I would buy an infection factory and not one that has STDs. All right? All right? So what I want you to do, I could make a Cleveland joke, but I'm from there and I won't. All right? So listen. Sorry, Cleveland. Sorry, Tammy. I love you. Home of the buzzer, WMMS. That's where I was born and raised. The 18 years of my life. And trust me. I'm familiar with infections. Okay. I was a fucking crazy kid. All right. So what I'm going to do is what I want you to do is, excuse me, cut down on affection, lots of accountability. All right. Dog should be calm. No petting when aroused. Make it work for its food. All right. Make sure you're working on duration work. So duration work, like right now, and I'm not saying this because I'm a dog trainer and because they're my dogs. All our clients' dogs can do this. You see dogs lying down, doing nothing. All the time. They're not bored. They're not shut down. They haven't been shocked into submission. They're being trained. Most dogs spend 20 hours a day doing nothing. Your dog should learn how to do nothing on command. Next.
Theos. When my GSD, 20 months, meets other dog and they try to take off, he growls. When and how should I correct this behavior? I have a dominant dog collar on him. This is while he is sniffing them still and they take off. Why is it that he growls?
Well, your dog shouldn't be meeting dogs on a leash. I don't want you to, so who's this, Theos? Mm-hmm. So I don't want your dog to meet other dogs. Guys, don't have your dog meet dogs or people out on a walk. Don't do it. It's not good protocol. It's not good protocol. The dog could be growling because it's frustrated because it can't give chase. There could be a million reasons why, but all I want to know, the easiest thing for me to tell you is let's go by the advice that I live and abide by. And I encourage my customers to do that as well. Don't meet dogs on walks ever. I want you and the dog to be one. And I want you to be the most important thing in your dog's life. And I don't want your dog to be interested in other dogs. That's not socializing. We do socialization. I'm a huge advocate of socialization. That's not socializing. Next.
Sammy Shipman. Hey, Jeff, just wondering if you got my email.
Yes, I got your email and I'm going to phone you, but we made a video that's pretty descriptive. Sammy's blind. And oh, Sammy, yeah. Do you think that video that we made is enough? If we played it, the audio on that is enough?
I'll have to listen to it.
But I'm going to give you a call tomorrow. All right. Next.
Josh, I was finally able to place both of my dogs next to each other for over an hour. They fell asleep. Thank you. P.S. Joelle is also awesome. She answers my IG DM questions.
You have a direct link to her? Do you? Really?
Is that on my personal or solid canine?
Listen, for the longest time, Joelle wouldn't answer the Instagram direct messages. She's like, Jeff, they're personal. I'm like, they better not be personal. It's on my business page. And if anybody's writing anything personal to me on my business page, ladies, a couple of dudes, but ladies, she reads.
I can see them.
She reads them. Okay. So all those photos you've been sending me, she sees them before I do. All right. So watch yourself, people. All right. You shouldn't be sending personal stuff. If you want to send me anything personal, Jeff at solidcaninetraining.com. She doesn't see any of that stuff. Next.
Sean, hey Jeff and Joelle, I have an 11-week-old Belgian Malinois. Any overall advice?
Find a dog trainer. Find one today. So a Belgian Malinois is, whenever I talk about dogs, I'm like, breed doesn't really matter much, except for when it comes to a bulldog, you need a life jacket when it's swimming and you got to be careful in the hot sun. And then a Belgian Malinois. It's a whole nother animal. I've only met one lazy one in my life. The rest of them are anywhere from high drive to batshit crazy. So, and I own one now. I've had one for 4 months. I came upon one. So I swore I would never get one, but I'm more than happy to have Tex till the end of his life, and he's only two. So I'll have him for a while and we're having a lot of fun. But what you need to do is, I would find a dog trainer right now, and you want to have a healthy balance. If you want to do sport, you need a healthy balance of family dog training. So I would find a family dog trainer that works with high drive breeds, not someone that's just positive. That dog's going to need to learn how to take a correction. So most males can blow through 100 on a remote and not miss a beat. All right, come on in. Hey, nope. Text. Sorry, guys. We got a little hug it out. Good night. I love you. You going to bed? Want to say goodnight to YouTube?
Goodnight, YouTube.
Goodnight, Ange.
You want to say goodnight to Ange?
Goodnight.
Goodnight.
Okay, who's putting you to bed tonight, Mama or your sisters? Really? Oh, wow. Look at you. You scored. Okay. So, Sean says, so that's what I want you to do. Find a dog trainer. But yeah, massive amount of structure. Watch the affection. Don't redirect the biting. Stop the biting. You can always teach controlled biting later. Tons of structure. Crate. You want that dog to love the crate. You literally want that dog to fall in love with the crate. How do you do that? You make it suck if they're a jerk in the crate. Next.
Top chat.
Top chat.
David Smith.
Wait, well, I'm not seeing these top chats.
Yeah. I got it.
Okay, cool. Go ahead.
Well, it's gone. Wait, the button just disappeared. Okay. What happened?
So go to the next one. I'll find it.
All right.
Red Riding Hood.
Yep. And the wolf. Hey, J&J. I was walking Kona in my apartment complex, and we ran into 5 different dogs, and each time she would flip out and try to lunge at them aggressively. What do I do to prevent her from acting aggressive when it happens so suddenly?
So number one, this is what you need to do. And you can look for David's thing to scroll down. What I need you to do is this. What are you walking your dog on? Are you walking your dog on at a minimum of a prong collar? And then the best option would be a prong collar, remote collar combo. What I want you to do is teach your dog remote collar heel, remote collar heel. Also, I don't want your dog to walk in arousal ever at all. Everybody thinks when they see our dogs that they're bored. They're not bored. They're not aroused. The last thing I want is a dog. People have to scale the information and listen to the narrative of the dogs we work with. We deal with human aggressive, dog aggressive, leash reactive dogs. The last thing we want these dogs to do is to be alert on a walk. The only thing we want these dogs to do is to be in follow mode. Your dog needs to be in follow mode. Therefore, any posturing, ears up, closed mouth, head forward, chest forward, anything but, yeah, man, let's go for a walk. Anything but that, correct way before. Next.
David Smith. Rocky did a counter surf again. Thought I had corrected. Guess he needs a reminder, but he's sneaky, so he knows he's breaking the rules. Glad to see ya.
He doesn't know he's breaking the rules. He's not that smart. Okay? So what I want you to do is, David, video camera, put up yummy food, release the dog in the kitchen, set him up, hit him for 3 seconds the way you're supposed to. Don't physically hit him. Okay, we use a remote collar on that. Next.
Scandalisa, I want to start training my GSD who lives outside at the moment so he can live inside. I've started working on place and some heel work outside. How much should he know before I introduce him to my cats? He fixates on them and it's hard to get his attention off of them.
You need a remote collar for that. You want to put him into avoidance. He's been probably chasing cats his whole life if he's an outside dog. I own an outside dog as well. Okay. Dog kills skunks. Dog goes after everything. All right. And he's outside. Let him. You come into my yard, you end up dead if you're not a human. Well, you're not a human if you're not family, you know. So what I want you to do is place is going to be your magic thing. He looks at the cats, make it suck to look at cats. Top chat, $5. That one I got. Rick, been e-collar training for 3 weeks, 3 dogs, 2 are doing well, 3rd still resisting, avoids eye contact, isolates himself in house, didn't before. You might be going too high too soon, Rick. What I want you to do is keep that dog on a leash. Is that dog on a leash at all times? Dog should be on a leash at all times. Remember, they're not magic buttons. You still got to do dog training, all right? So you're making great progress with 2. Boom, kudos to you. Guess what? They're not all going to be that easy. It's going to be a lot of work. Keep the dog on a leash. Make sure you're not overwhelming that dog. No corrections at all. You should be pairing it with food. Next.
Top chat,
$10. Callie M, I work at a doggy daycare. I bring my dog. I punish an e-collar when going after dogs and resource guarding it that at me. At work, I've trained him on place and crate, heel and down. What am I doing wrong? I don't know. What are you doing wrong? Well, is it a daycare center? Is every dog, can you punish every dog for unwanted behavior and for over-arousal? Are you throwing your dog into the mix of all these out of control dogs and expecting your dog to behave? It's too much. So, you know, at work, I've trained him on place, on crate. So your dog, if you bring your own personal dog to doggy daycare, your dog should be lying down in a crate almost all day long. And during your break, you take him outside, you go for a walk, you play chuck it. That's what you should do with your personal dog. Next.
If I decipher the question properly. Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. She has a 3 millimeter prong and an e-collar with long winged contact points.
Okay. What you need to do is correct the dog way before it gets aroused. I never want that dog to be in an aroused state on a walk. Next.
It's D-Rod. I have 3 dogs, 11-year-old Shih Tzu mix, 4-year-old Shih Tzu, and a 4-year-old GSD. The 2 4-year-olds don't get along, which results in the Shih Tzu attacking the GSD.
Tell the fucking GSD to man up. Take the little Shih Tzu out. Right at the fucking kneecaps. You're going to be kidding me. It's a Shih Tzu. Yo, German Shepherd. Come on, represent. So this is what I want you to do. You have to stop the Shih Tzu. All right? You got a shitty Shih Tzu. What you need to do is you need to bonk the Shih Tzu or you will end up with a dead Shih Tzu. The German Shepherd at one point will say, you know what? I have had enough. I've been listening to this Gellman character long enough, and it's time for me to freaking be proactive and clear shit out. So what I want you to do is when that Shih Tzu goes after the German Shepherd, you correct it. Correct it with a bonker, but don't throw this at the German Shepherd. Correct it with a leash pop, but also how much structure is in your life? Are all 3 dogs living in crates? Can they all do place? Do they all eat separately? Do they all listen to different commands? And do they all know no? So what you need to do is advocate for this German Shepherd. Just because it's a larger dog, that doesn't mean it's the bully. It sounds like your Shih Tzu is being the bully, which happens all the time with these small dogs. I own 2 Chihuahuas. So what I want you to do is hold the Shih Tzu accountable. Next.
Angela says, hello, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Angela.
Hey, Angela. Expat, is it a good idea to use a healing stick in a dog park with a bunch of left wingers around?
I don't know what a left winger is at all. I don't get into politics at all, even though I love Ben Shapiro. But, you know, chances are no. Probably not with any political party doesn't agree with healing sticks. Next.
Greg says, we recently had a dog park shut down in northern Colorado because there was so much shit everywhere. Just gross.
Huh. Gross. I guess that little sign that says clean up your shit wasn't paid attention. Next. You got fecal everywhere. So many diseases can live through the winter in Colorado and crop up in the spring. There's some pretty hardy freaking diseases out there. Mm-hmm. Next.
Kaylee J, usually get frustrated very quickly when my dog has one of his whine scream episodes. Managed to stay calm and quiet this time and kept correcting with e-collar until he stopped.
Kelly J, I'm impressed. You've been practicing your breathing exercises like we practiced on the last show. By the way, guys, at 25 minutes, we do 10 minutes of breathing. Just kidding. Next.
Pool Sands. Hello. First time watching your show. My question is, how do you stop a puppy from biting?
First of all, define puppy. 14 weeks and older? Just take your freaking hand and put it in its mouth. Or you actually can use punishment from that. Number one, your puppy. How much time is your puppy spending in the crate? Your average 14-week and under puppy should be spending 20 hours a day in a crate. Not continuous, but that's how much time. They sleep about 20 hours a day. Next thing you know, are you carrying the dog around too much? Are you playing too rough with that dog? What is that dog working for? Is it working for its food? It should be eating it, not eating out of a bowl, but it should be eating out of a little treat pouch. Take its daily kibble and train it. Sit, down, place, recall, all with food rewards. Then what I want you to do is stop unwanted behavior. Any jumping or any biting, you would use a bonker. It's a cotton towel. It won't hurt your dog. You say no, wait a second, and then bonk your dog. So puppies don't bite me. Puppies don't jump on me. Literally, I can pick up a 10-week-old puppy, and if it tries to bite me one time, it'll never bite me again. Why? Because I practice what I preach. It's not because I'm a miracle worker or have all this knowledge. Everything I put out for free. So that's what I want you to do. You're going to hear from a lot of people, though. Don't do that. You're using fear to train the dog. Yeah, you should be afraid of biting me. I'm not going to fucking reward you for not biting me. I'm going to punish you for biting me. But I'm not mad at you. I'm not upset with you. Let's go about our day. You're going to hear that you'll never build a relationship with a dog. No. If you don't stop biting, you won't build a relationship with the dog because you won't own that dog. Most dogs are surrendered pre-1 years old. Next.
One purpose. What's up, Jeff and Joelle? I have a great shirt or coffee mug saying, what I want you to do.
Did we write that one down already?
I will now.
She has a shitload of them written down. Awesome. Yeah. Thank you, One Purpose.
Raquel from Brazil.
Hey Jeff Raquel, and Joelle. I love you.
I started my podcast recently, and I was wondering if you have any suggestions to convert the YouTube videos into SoundCloud audio.
That would be a Melissa question. You have to download it, separate the sound, the audio from it, and then you can upload it on SoundCloud. Go to the SoundCloud help desk; they'll tell you how to do it. Next.
Is this Sabrina spelled backwards?
Yes.
Nervous? Sabrina.
Yes. Yeah.
Forest, not woods.
That could be a phrase for a mug. Forest, not woods. Write it down. Next.
Got it. The Kate. Oh, just kidding. Karen.
Yep.
Hey, Jeff and Janelle. Janelle's my sister.
Yep. It's okay.
Thanks so much for doing the show and providing free content. It helped me tremendously. You were awesome.
Karen, thank you so much. And I'm being sincere. I'm actually being sincere on all the questions. Whether I'm smirky or not, I'm sincere. But thank you.
All right. The Kate, Joelle, what did you do before dog training? Jeff, what did you do before sex shops? And did you find out if that was the real Peter North that was on a few weeks ago?
Joelle?
I was a property manager before dog training.
And married.
He loves to throw that one out there.
Well, you were.
Yeah.
Well, you still are.
Were.
You still are legally. I mean, right. You're not coming in with the freaking paperwork dancing around.
Not yet.
The staff hasn't had a divorce party for you yet.
No. Nope.
With Peter North.
It's coming.
So I was in, let's see. I've done a lot of stuff. I started my first job at 9 years old, shining shoes on street corners. I was in the restaurant business for a long time. And then I owned sex shops for 15 years. Before that, I was waited tables. I worked 3 jobs doing multiple stuff. I dabbled in drug dealing for a little bit. I did a lot of different things. Next. I tried going to university. I worked at a deli.
But you did get a degree.
Yeah, we went over that the other day. Yep. And I don't know if that was a real Peter North. Next.
Chevy says, haha, natural. That's what they call it here when you use only your body language and actions and no tools. I guess it's like OG Caesar.
Yeah, that's great. You know, that's great for some people, but not for like our clients. Do you know what I mean? Our clients can't do that. That's why we utilize tools, because it's not the skill of the dog trainer. We have to empower our clients to be able to do that as well. Next.
Amy and the boys, 12. Jeff, I love your shirt. I'm such a flamingo girl.
Thank you very much.
His ego just got eaten.
I'm going to go down to Florida just to shop at Bell's so I can buy more shirts.
So you got it, Bell's?
Yeah. Damn right I did.
Nice. Brianna Wright, what is the best thing to do with a hyper dog? She is trained on place and I use place every day. And in between place, we play check it a few times a day, but it just doesn't seem to be enough.
So you'll never tire your dog out. Like my dogs, I've got high drive working line German Shepherds and Mals. I'll never tire them out. And I don't try to tire them out. I exercise them a fair amount. Okay. I exercise them a fair amount. And then I just do plots. And then I just do place. And if they get aroused, you correct the arousal. Next.
Cool Sands. My question is, how do you stop puppy play bite?
I already answered that question before. Yes. Up above. Next.
Kaylee J. Still working on eliminating his whining. He'll do great for a few days. Then one day he's particularly whiny and screams when I correct him with the e-collar. Leash pop bonker. Staying consistent.
Stay consistent. But guess what? Cut out all affection. Create distance. And work that dog on every part of his life. Got it? Really tighten up everything. Next.
Top chat.
Top chat. We know that. We know that.
That's David Smith.
Hey, David. Just a bit to help pay for that awesome looking dinner I saw on Instagram. Thanks for everything. David, we need it. Okay? We need that $5. Oh, my God. Let's see. Now we got another 305 left. To go. Yeah. It was one of my favorite restaurants. Next. Thank you so much. I appreciate it, David. David, thanks for tagging me on those on the Instagram photos today. I want you to know that I actually really, really appreciate it. I really do. Next.
Gary Wright. Hi guys. First, I would like to thank you deeply. My wife passed away last week. She was allowed to get a hospital visit from our GSD as she missed him so much because of your advice. It was made possible.
Wow, holy shit, Gary. I'm so sorry for your loss. Fuck, dying sucks. It just really sucks. Well, thank you. Next.
Horse Crazy 92. My Maltese is not standard size, and I believe he is overweight. My vet said he was fine 4 years ago at 15 pounds, and now he is 18 pounds on a diet. Been on a diet for 1 year. Haven't lost anything, part one. I'm worried about him stealing the other dog's food and putting them on a schedule feeding. What else should I be doing to help? Don't have anywhere close to walk them. Too dangerous. Could be a good play. Help.
Okay. This is it, guys.
Oh, could a good help play.
Okay.
Could a good play help.
This is it. All you folks out there, unless your dog has got a medical issue, I don't want to hear that you can't get your dog to lose weight. You're all full of shit. All of you are. Okay? This is the thing. Less calories in, the dog loses weight. Exercise, the dog loses weight. Combination of both, they lose weight and they get into shape. So I can fluctuate my dog's 10 pounds in a month if I have to. Literally, I can put 10 pounds on them. I can take 10 pounds off of them. It's probably unhealthy as fuck to do it, but I could do it. Why? I feed all my dogs in crates. They get a certain amount of food. They eat in 5 minutes and then it goes. They don't get any snacks in between because they don't need it. If I wanted to really put on weight, what would I do? I would give them more food to eat and I would probably cut down on their exercise. But even if I give them the same amount of exercise, what I would do is I would just still give them more food. If I want to cut my dog's weight, I cut my dog's weight. I then take away from their food and I can either standard amount of exercise or even more exercise. It's a mathematical equation. Calories are math. 3,500 kilocalories per pound. It is a math equation. So I'm not trying to be rude to anybody, but if you can have your dog live with me for a week, it'll lose 3 pounds. It'll lose 3 pounds. Now you have to be a little bit slower on your small breed dogs because you have to be really, really careful. So I got Chihuahuas. You have to be really, really careful. They can only lose so much, but you could do it. Less food. If you're worried that your dog is stealing food, then they should be eating in separate crates. Next.
Pat donated $1.99.
Nice. Oh, wow. Pat, thank you.
Gary Wright said, so again, I thank you as it cheered her up so much.
Thank you, Gary. And again, sorry for your loss, buddy.
Yep. Blue on Black says,
sucks.
Gary Wright, so sorry about your loss.
Yeah.
Nicole says, Gary, so great that you were able to make that happen. Sorry for your loss.
Yeah, stick around, Gary. I'm sure a lot of people got condolences. Yep, next.
Yeah. Jane, when walking my dog and another dog comes, he will go into a staring mode.
Yep.
He does this with people too. He will stay in heel. He never barks and has never been aggressive. Should it be corrected?
Yeah, that's a good, Jane, that's a really, really good question. So theoretically, you don't have to, but let's make you a little bit more important. So I would, if you have a remote collar for the dog, you would just correct, boom, the dog goes, oh, I just want you to be everything, Jane. I want you to be everything for your dog. Because the reason why is because when you do start doing off-leash stuff with your dog, it's going to make a dramatic difference. It's going to make a dramatic difference. Next.
Greg says, oh my God, yes. I called a dog fight at Tokyo Jones once. Lady let her big ass lab drag her to a bully. I go, here it comes, guys. Lab was bumping the pit. 10 seconds later, it was on.
Yep, exactly. Mm-hmm. Next, Greg.
Angela says, Jeff, nice shirt. I'm not trying to be fresh, but that's my favorite shirt of yours.
Angela, you can be fresh with me anytime, baby. All right. I can use
just some, not on IG.
I can use some fresh. All right. Just don't send me shit on Instagram, ladies, because she sees it. Right?
Julie, wish we never had to kennel our dog, but on occasion, it's our only option. When we pick him up, he's regressed in noise and leash reactivity. Is it just built up adrenaline?
Oh, are you talking about like send it to a kennel? I mean, if you're talking about sending it to a kennel, then yeah. I mean, your average kennel is literally a shit show. It's filled with barking dogs. It's just all barking, barking, barking. Like, I've parked my RV next to kennels that I've done seminars in, and it's literally 24/7 barking. I've been in people's kennels where the staff has to wear head protectors like the landscapers do, or when I go shooting that I use for air protection. Like, you know, you're better off trying to get a pet sitter to come to your house, you know? Also, it could be, yeah, your dog's just been cooped up. Next.
Did you read Rick Maloney's top chat?
I didn't see it, no.
Been e-collar training for 3 weeks, three.
Yes, days. Yes, okay. Yes, yeah, three out of two. Two out of three, yeah.
Mackenzie Jordan, hi Jeff and Joelle. I love listening to your show. I'm a dog walker and was tired of getting dragged around on front clip harnesses. Glad I found your videos, with the owner's permission, of course.
Hey, so Mackenzie, let's have some fun. The only way you take clients is if you can walk dogs on any tool you want. You put it right on your website. Those are the rules. That's it. And you're like, oh my God, nobody will call me. Yeah, they will. They'll call you. That's what I would do. Next.
Gabriel, Joelle, have you been bit by a dog yet? No, not at Solid Canine.
Nope. None of us are getting bit.
Mm-mm.
None of us are getting bit. Well, guys, we deal with some of the most human aggressive dogs there is. The dog that just came in bit somebody in the face, right?
Mm-hmm.
17 stitches or something?
A lot. Enough to go to the hospital.
Yeah. We just, that deaf white dog bit somebody in the face today. Not today. The white dog that came in today bit someone in the face. Mozart bit 6 people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we had almost every dog we deal with is a biting dog. My staff doesn't get bit. We deal with dog aggressive dogs. We're not having dog fights. How? We have a skill set that not a lot of people have, but also we really understand dogs. And we take things slow, and we use muzzles, and we also punish arousal sometimes on day one. Like this concept of, oh, you need to build a relationship with a dog. That's the stupidest idea and the most dangerous thing you can do as a trainer. Now, for your own dog, sure, you want to build a relationship. As a trainer, you don't want to build a relationship with that dog. It's not your dog to build a relationship with. Now, that doesn't mean you won't build a relationship over the 3 to 5 weeks. Don't get me wrong. But I'm saying a lot of these people that are trying to build relationships and then train, you're letting this dog figure you out. And that's when you get dangerous. And that's when you start trusting a dog and then they go after you. I've seen it time and time and time again. Nope. You're like the school teacher that comes in that doesn't smile until Christmas. And you run your classroom like a boot camp. And then on Christmas, they're like, holy shit, Mr. Gellman's a really nice guy. It's like, I know I am. I was a nice guy in September, but you little rugrats, I got 7 kids. I love children. I actually want to work with kids. And it wouldn't look anything like this, by the way. If you ever see me work with my kids at a seminar, you'll understand how I work with children. It's way different than this, right? I do say fuck though, which that's why I can't get hired anywhere. So, but what it is it's like, no, I was always nice. I won't show you any softness, not kindness. I will always show kindness. I won't show you the good stuff though, the softness, until you show me that you deserve it. It's the same with dogs. Next.
Mm-hmm. Nicole M. made and posted two videos since we talked on Wednesday, Patreon Skype. Thanks for the push to be brave.
Nicole, you are fucking brave.
He's good at that.
You are. That's what I do, by the way. You should see what
push,
I
push, push, push.
I pushed her.
Yeah.
Like you wouldn't believe.
Yep. Still do.
Every day I do.
Every day.
Every day. Yep. Man, you have changed in 4 months. Yeah. Whole different person. That's what I do. I push people. You know why I push people? Because there's no secret to success. And 95 to 98% of the people will never reach that in their lives because they're afraid. And the most of them are afraid of what other people think of them. Why would you care what other people think of you? Who gives a shit? Next.
Sean, in reference to your answer about my question regarding my Malinois, how should I fix his biting? Thank you.
So just the same way I've like, see, well, if it's a Malinois puppy, 11 weeks old, say no and bonk the dog. But it depends on the genetics of that dog. That dog might go into defense. I mean, I don't know what kind of Malinois you have, but if that was like a finely bred Malinois, that's a sport dog. And that dog will, and a trainer will probably want to redirect that. That's what a lot of the trainers do. And with family pet dogs, I don't encourage redirecting. If I was a sport dog trainer, I probably would want to develop that bite, but I don't know enough about that. So, but for biting, you always make biting suck. Next.
Liz, my half mal pup makes me feel like the 93-year-old lady with the 8-week-old puppy.
Yep, exactly.
Muharram says hi.
Hey, how are you?
Ron. Hey, J&J. It's Ron from the STL. You two look great tonight. Joelle, how do you work with Jeff without laughing your ass off?
Because I'm not like this. At,
I'm not
like this at work.
No, he's pretty serious.
Right.
Julian.
What's a nub?
Noob.
What's a noob?
I don't know.
Oh, African,
a troll word.
African penguin still called me a noob. Well, this noob has a pretty fucking popular show, so okay, I'll take it. Thanks. Let's put that on a fucking coffee cup. Hey, noob. Write that one down. Thanks for the idea. Hey, noob. Next.
Julian, how would you go about correcting a dog that is in constant arousal on walks? How often would you hit the button? Would you hold or tap it, then wait? Haven't seemed to find the right one yet.
What I would do is the beginning of the walk. I talked about this last week at the show. On the show, literally the beginning of the walk, right out the front steps, you're out the front steps, your dog is a little bit in front of you, it's looking around, that's your biggest correction of the freaking day right there. Got it? I want you to start your walks out that way. And anybody out there that's ever done that before will attest, it's a life changer, it's a game changer. Next.
Okay, name the movie. What do you get when you cross a shih tzu with a bulldog?
I don't know.
Okay. Bullshit.
Okay, guys, this is my show. Next.
Made me laugh.
Have your own damn show, Kate.
Sabrina, while grooming my American Eskimo, he shakes and literally turns into an alligator at any pull, especially on his tail end. 60 stim didn't do anything. I need 3 hands. Do I tie him up and watch lip curl?
Sabrina, you're asking me a grooming question. I don't have a skill set for that. So the way I would fix that, believe it or not, is yeah, I would bonk the dog and then I probably would use food and a clicker to start getting the dog used to the grooming. But I don't groom, so I don't know. But say if it was, pretend it was touching the dog every time you try to touch. So I would bonk the dog to stop the bad behavior, and then I would use clicker and food to start training what I wanted. Next.
The Hawk Warrior. How do you build confidence in approaching objects? My dog gets fearful with random new things, and I want him to be able to approach something with curiosity, not fear. Scared of things like cones and I don't know where the rest of the thing is, but.
So this is the thing. You might just own a fearful dog. So a lot of dogs don't have good recovery time. So you just might not own a confident dog. How do you build your dog's confidence up? By literally being a proper leader. By being a proper leader, right now, don't let your dog make so many choices. Don't let your dog make those choices. What I want you to do is lead your dog. So literally focus on like, we're walking by that. Let's go. We're walking past that sound. We're walking past that environmental. Asking your dog to go up to a cone that it's deathly afraid of, it's not going to right now. A lot of dogs don't have that recovery time. So it's very common when you like, I don't do puppy picking out, but say you take a metal bowl, you drop it on the ground, the dog, like most dogs should be a little bit startled. Like the dog that doesn't even get phased, it might be deaf, seriously. Or it's like, whoa, like, do you want a personal pet that isn't phased by that? Most dogs will go, oh my gosh, what was that? And then a lot of the puppies, if you watch a litter of puppies, they'll go in and they'll investigate. Some dogs will stay back. The ones that stay back, those are the ones you don't get either. The ones that have, they go back, but then they recover rather quickly. Those are the ones you're going to get. But when you adopt a dog, you don't have the opportunity to usually do these tests. And I don't do these tests. This is not, that's above my skill set. I don't pick out dogs. I don't pick out puppies. Okay. I just fix the unwanted behaviors. But what I would do with this dog and what we do with these dogs is boom, let's go, move them by it. Also, we have the dogs go in place. Places go to a dog bed, don't move, and we bring the environmentals around. And then we correct for breaking the place. And then they get desensitized to the environmentals. Next.
Ice-Ski Big Sky, I've sent two more people to your YouTube channel. Woo woo.
All right, thanks.
Awesome. Karen, crazy question. Do you teach your dogs to break the break command? My dog will stay in place but doesn't get up on the release command. Use leash pressure. Sorry, Joelle, about your name earlier. Misspell. No worries.
That's okay. Yeah, break. I say break all the time. Watch my Instagram live. Yeah, I mean, we always say break. So break, but break is an English word. It might be other word. They might say break in other languages as far as English, but I only know it as an English word. So it's an English word that the dog doesn't understand. I can make break mean roll over. I can make break mean sit. I can make break mean high five. I can make break mean play dead. I can make break mean anything. It's just a word. So what do? Leash, guide the dog off. Next. Reward off of place. Got it? Break. Pull the dog off. Food reward. Next.
Kelly M., come to Florida. You can do a seminar.
We are doing a seminar in Florida. Go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. jeffgellmanseminars.com. You can go there. We'll go to Jeff Gellman. You can go there or go to What Would Jeff Do? You can go there. And you'll see our seminar schedule. We'll be in Florida in February, I think, or January. Or February. Look at the schedule. We'll be there. Don't worry.
Yeah. Raquel says, thank you. I'm loving the show more and more every week.
Oh, wow. Thanks, Raquel. Where have you been, Raquel? I've been doing this damn show for 12 years.
Chevy says, so true. Not everyone can be Caesar. By the way, finally got Lika, my dog aggressive working line GSD, onto the treadmill. She was awesome and loved it. Walked 30 minutes right off the bat and would have gone longer if I let her.
Well, you know, Chevy. Huh?
Nice.
I guess that side submitted that I suggested worked on the treadmill, huh? Next.
Kaylee J, currently thinking about starting some scent work with my dog for an activity over the winter. Any resources you suggest?
There's got to be great online resources. Just go on to YouTube. Next.
Gal Jez. Hey, guys. Hey, Gal Jez.
Hey, Gal Jez. How are you?
Grant Noble, how did you meet and get close with Linda? What marriage advice can you give us?
I met her at a fetish club because I used to run a fetish night at Club Hell. I met her there, and then she would come in every Wednesday night because that's the night that I hosted. That's where I used to get I got shot at by bikers, and we had a deal with the Hell's Angels, and you had to dress up and drag. The Hell's Angels didn't. You had to dress up and drag to get in there, or wear all black or fetish gear, and we had like politicians and high heels and little nursemaid outfits and people in diapers with little bottles and all kinds of S&M stuff going on. And she used to go there every night. And I would say to George, the bouncer, I'm going to marry her one day. And I used to always see her flirting around with a bunch of guys. And one night I did something very unprofessional because I never mix business with pleasure. Ever. My father instilled that into my mind. He's taught me how to rotate milk. One of the first lessons in life. First lessons in life was how to rotate milk. He owned a pharmacy, Cam's Rexall Pharmacy at 165th and Lorraine in Cleveland, Ohio. This is before CVS and Walgreens was around. He showed me how to rotate milk. And then he also told me, you don't shit where you eat. He told me that. He also taught me, don't ever expect thank yous after holiday bonuses from your staff. He taught me that. And then he told me a bunch of stuff about stealing, but that's before like there was PayPal and we're a cashless company right now. So I did something unprofessional. I walked up to a client and I said, which was Linda, and I said, I see you making out with all these dudes. When's my turn? And boom, we haven't been separated since. Next. So what can I tell you for marriage? That's not marriage. That's how to get a hot chick to marry you. As far as marriage advice, that's a long freaking thing. One thing I can tell you right now is if you're ever having a really, really bad day, don't go directly home. Got it? Don't go directly home. Go somewhere, chill out, and then, but call though. Say, honey, I'm having a rough time right now. I need 15 minutes. You come home and you fucking keep your mouth fucking closed, because the first thing out of your mouth, you're going to be a dick. Don't be a dick. Now, if you don't have the opportunity to blow off steam for 15 minutes, and when blow off steam, I don't mean yelling and screaming. Come home and you have to have this discussion with your spouse. Honey, some days when I come home, I might just say to you, hey, I'm going to go up in my room and read a book. That's code word for you've had a rough day and you need a little bit of a downtime. Don't communicate with your spouse. The first thing out of your mouth, you'll be a dick. Don't be a dick. Next.
Top chat.
Top chat, $5. Doug Lang, $5. Thank you. There you go. I should give him more marriage advice. Next. We're talking about fetish clubs.
Yeah. Right. Carl and Morgan have a 6-pound chihuahua. When we are food training, she sits and downs happily and takes reward. Mm. About 1 to 2 minutes in, she starts to shut down, acts submissive, and stops taking food.
So don't feed her. Make sure you're not. It's a chihuahua. They don't need. They need much food. So I would use the smallest piece of kibble or the smallest piece of kibble and only feed during training and never feed out of a food bowl and switch to clicker training as your marker. Next.
Pat says she tried to donate $5.
Okay, but it came as $1.99. Don't worry about it. The thought's there. Next.
Carlin, she was free fed for 3 years before I got her, so her relationship with food is a bit odd.
So stop free feeding her. Literally, you're going to just feed her during training. Next.
The Kate, Gary, it was so amazing that you were able to give that gift to your wife. My sincerest condolences.
Yeah. Next.
Karen says she's so sorry for your loss, Gary.
Terrible. Next.
Shana, hey Jeff, I want to do T3. When is the next availability in Rhode Island or New York City?
Never New York City.
Next. Already started saving money and cutting back on a lot of things. I look forward to seeing you all.
So Shana, we're going to do one in California, the 18th through the 24th in Chatsworth. We usually do one, I think, in June in Rhode Island. Next.
Mm-hmm. The life. Oh, actually, there's $1.99 top chat. Dog is scared on walks. How to desensitize her?
Make sure you're using the proper tools that we recommend. Prong collar to minimum, and then teach the dog how to properly heel. And what you're doing is get the dog to focus on heel. If it tries to break heel because of an environmental, because it's afraid, correct it. It sounds mean to do. You're correcting your dog when it's afraid. Trust me, we do it all the time and it works great. Next.
All right. This is a 3-part question. The life of Ray.
What the hell? This is like, we got a million questions to go still. Next.
What should you do if your dog favors one person over you, no matter how much time that you spend with them? Is there anything that could be done? It's a female border collie. The same border collie also, whenever a motor or sound goes off, specifically the sump pump downstairs.
So there's two different, too many questions. You got way too many questions there. The first one. Okay. How do you have a better relationship with your dog? Your dog just might not like you for some weird reason. I don't know. What can you do? Become everything to your dog. Be demanding of your dog. Believe it or not, more love and affection doesn't build bonds. Hold your dog accountable. That's what builds bonds. So hold your dog accountable. That's what you're going to do. Keep your dog on a leash. Give it a command. Train it to do the command. And if it breaks command, correct it. That's what you do. That's how you get respect in your dog's eyes, believe it or not. Love and affection doesn't do it. Everybody thinks it does, but it doesn't. Next.
Do you want me to keep going with these three-parters?
Sure.
All right. So, any way to stop the habit? The dog, like, freaks out when there's loud noises.
Freaks out. Teach you. What we do is this. We correct the arousal. Put the dog in place, sort of down. Invite the loud noise in. If the dog breaks command, you correct for breaking the command. Then the dog focuses on the command and they don't, and they stop it. They start ignoring the environmental and they get over it. Next.
Julie, I've been told putting a weighted dog backpack on our dog will help him stay focused on walks in addition to the prong collar. Any truth to this? I'm skeptical. Also, can you recommend a CBD oil brand?
I can't recommend a CBD oil brand at all. There's too many of them out there, and I'm not qualified, nor do I have the skill set, but I'm a big fan of CBD. As far as the weighted dog pack, we've never used a weighted dog pack on a dog. Well, I've gone backpacking with my dogs, and the dogs seem to focus on us fine. Try it. If it works, that's fine. The bottom line is, sounds like whoever gave that advice doesn't want to tell their dog not to cut the shit, though. So a lot of people are trying to add things to the thing, but they don't want to give the dog a correction. So, but try it. If you want to use a weighted vest, just make sure that the majority of the weight is on the shoulders, not the back. Next.
Jorge. Hello, guys. My dog eats too fast, looks desperate, never satisfied, eats like crazy. Why does this happen?
What? Have you seen humans? Like, go to Vegas, go to the Bellagio buffet.
That's me every night.
It's $35.95, at least the last time I was there. All right? And freaking watch people. They're fucking like, blah, 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 blah. Sushi, crab legs, get me some steak. Honey. Put the desserts in your handbag. We'll take them back to the room. What do you mean, why does he do that? It's a fucking animal. That's why he does it. So what I want you to do is get a cookie pan. Mind, I'm trying to do a show here. Get a cookie pan, okay? Or get cupcake dishes, tins, and put the food, spread the food out. Or take all the food, throw it on the ground, or use food for training. Next.
You're going to end up smacking me in the face one of these
nights. Oh, sorry.
Three people are saying that noob means somebody new to the game or an amateur.
Oh, I'm, well.
Amateur hour.
Okay, I'm not new to the game. I might be an amateur, but I'm not new to the game. Next.
Tony Cash. There's another one. Noob means beginner. Heather S. Got it. How to help a dog overcome fear of the blow dryer?
What you would do is, we do this all the time, vacuum, blow dryer, leaf blower, ATV, put your dog in place, which is lying down on a mat, and then introduce the blow dryer, vacuum, introduce the blow dryer or whatever environmental it is, turned off, okay? If a dog breaks place, correct it. Don't blow the damn dog, all right? Oh, hello. It's another good rule of thumb, by the way. All right.
If we're how old are you? Seriously.
What?
With your immature, like your immature jokes.
You really think a 12-year-old can make a bestiality joke?
I don't know.
No way. Blowjob joke, sure. Bestiality, not even, that's not even on the radar.
I didn't call you 12. I just said, how old are you?
Okay. I'll be 50. I'll be 52. You
said 12.
Okay, I'll be 52. You're calling me a child. Okay. So listen, what I want you to do is then turn on the blow dryer, and then at a distance, you start introducing it. If the dog breaks command, correct it. Next.
Indie woman. I have a 10-month-old Saint Bernard. He is loving, loves other people and dogs, but oh my, I tried training when he was 12 weeks old. He ate the jacket off me at 10 months. Worse. Suggestions?
You keep going.
Oh, I can't walk him as he gets too excited and pulls me on into walls. I'm tired. He is slowly eating my backyard, such as patio squares, grill tires.
All right. So first of all, you have a Saint Bernard that is outpowering you and you can't control. That's what it boils down to. And it's only going to get worse. It's only going to get worse. So what you need is you need one-on-one training is what you need. Or you need to send your dog to a board and train, or you need a really good trainer to come to your house and literally give you an incredible head start. The first thing you need to do, though, is you need to understand the concepts of dog training. So we have to start there. So I want you to go, you're brand new to my world. I want you to jump down the rabbit hole of my videos. There's 5,000 of them out there. What I want you to do is get a proper prong collar, 3-millimeter prong collar for this dog. I want you to make sure you start teaching this dog how to walk properly on a leash, the place command, how to go in its kennel. I want you to cut out all affection. None. This dog deserves no affection. It's destroying your home. All it deserves is a freaking bill at the end of the month. All right? And I want you to make sure that everything you do is permission-based. You have to learn how to properly correct your dog. Now, since you've got a dog that literally has spent the last 2 months doing what it wants to do, the first time you correct it, it actually might turn on you. I'm not saying that to scare you. And I'm not saying that because corrections make dogs aggressive. But this dog has had free rein its whole life. And for once, you're going to tell it, you who it doesn't respect, this is no disrespect for you, you who it doesn't respect, you're going to tell this dog that it can't do it. And you know what it's going to say? Let me show you that I can. And it's going to use all St. Bernard, 100 pound of its body, and I'll muscle you. So if I were you, I would find somebody that actually can help you dramatically at least get a head start. Any balance trainer, if you find, don't look for positive only. They can't do shit for you. Trust me, they can't. And if they could, I'd love to see all these great videos out there of them rehabbing dogs. Okay. This is a movie studio. There's no excuse for laziness out there. For all these people that are out there saying, oh, you don't have to do that. You can do this. Really, take a video. Show me. Not with a stuffed dog either. With a real dog. Trainers are actually, I fixed leash reactivity. And they're showing their dog walk by stuffed animals. This is real. And people are like, oh my God, that's incredible. Like, they're getting millions of hits on their videos on YouTube. I'm like, are you guys fucking stupid? Are you all that stupid? I mean, I'm blown away at people that are like, it's a stuffed dog. Have you seen the videos? I'm amazed by it. I'm amazed. Millions of views. Oh my gosh, you're the most incredible dog trainer. I'm like, what am I missing here? In my world, dogs go after dogs. I'm blown away. So you want to find somebody that actually can work with dogs. Next. You actually need a Skype session from me. Next.
Sabrina, trying to fine-tune him in case a kid touches or pulls him from behind just in case. Food is out because of fear. So just want to teach no bite no matter what. Hate to admit he got me. Okay, just stim at 100. Okay to just stim at 100.
No, I don't want you to stim at 100. This is what I want you to do. If you're worried about kids, carry a hiking stick with you and learn how to fucking whip it around your head. You'll clear out the whole freaking, trust me. Okay? 6-foot stick. If I remember my math right, I barely made it through school, but I'm pretty sure you multiply that by 3.14, 18.84 square feet of space you could clear out. Is that right, guys? Somebody help me out there. But then you have to go with the trajectory of your arm, too. So 6-foot stick, and then if your arm's 2 feet, you got 8 feet. So that's 8 times 3.14, which changes things. Right? That'd be 25 point something, right? About 25 square feet. I think that's how you figure out like square footage or radius. I don't know. You know the terminology. All right.
Circumference.
That was the word I was looking for. So what I want you to do is muzzle up the dog and teach that dog how to take a proper correction. Next.
Angela says, make it suck. Insert undesirable behavior. There's a coffee mug slogan.
There you go. Next.
I do want one that says make it suck.
Yep.
Blue on Black says Mozart bit 6 people. Great line.
Yep.
Sabrina says, I read that. Russ says, hey, Jeff and Joelle, good to see you guys.
Hey, Russ. Hey, Russ. You're killing it. Russ.
Nice picture on Facebook Russ, today.
Guess what I'm doing? I'm putting up my bar mitzvah picture tomorrow.
Please do it.
I'm putting up my bar mitzvah picture, okay?
Do it.
But he was raised Orthodox, though. I was raised Reform. It's a different look.
Just put it up.
And trust me, it's a different look. Okay.
Good post.
Next. By the way, Russ, you're brave.
You are.
Okay. You are brave and I love you. And that's what's going to make you successful.
Mm-hmm.
You got that, Russ? You are brave. I love you. And that is why you are going to be successful. Not because I love you, it's because you're brave. Next.
Linda, explain how to take a dog out to pee on leash. Do you let them on loose leash? Do you use the prong collar?
I mean, this is going to be personal choice, Linda. I mean, I personally just let my dogs out in my yard and they go, they pee and they poo and then I call them back in. But on a leash, theoretically, if your dog is on a leash, you never want it to be pulling, whether it's a pee break or you're starting a walk break. So what you would do is, you would use every opportunity you have to train the dog. So you would heel your dog. to the potty spot. And this is what I do. And then I plant my feet and I say, go potty. And then I plant my feet, and I usually use a 6-foot leash. So now my dog has 6 feet of space to walk around in. And this concept of like, oh, it has to find the perfect bush. No, it doesn't. You have 6 feet to figure out what the perfect potty spot is. I think that's very, very generous. I also want dogs to learn how to go to the bathroom on command. Why? Well, I like to travel with my dogs. So I want my dogs to be able to get out of the car, get out of my RV, go to the bathroom. If I'm running late for something, and if I've got to go stop home for 10 minutes, I want to be able to have my dogs go to the bathroom and then stop whatever. So that's what you can do. A couple of things. It teaches your dog how to go to the bathroom on command. Number two, it teaches your dog how to go into a particular spot, and then it's a win-win. Next.
Reg Bell, laughing emojis. I need to be more bold.
Yes, you need to be bold.
Mm-hmm.
Boldness wins. Next.
Raquel says, I've been here the whole time for years now. I always watch the show. You know that. I love you too much to give you up.
Raquel.
So sweet.
Yeah. Well, we're in love.
Oh, that's so nice.
She's my Brazilian love.
Nice.
The only one.
Cool.
I'm glad there's 90 other countries. So thank God.
God.
Next.
Katie Cat, we have learned more from your videos than 2 failed group obedience classes. Yeah. The classes were super expensive and a painful experience for us and the dog. We are finally making progress with place.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. There's a lot of crappy dog trainers out there. Mm-hmm. And you know what I mean? It's like, I mean, what are you going to do, right? I mean, what are you going to do? I mean, I think in 2018, I think everybody can get a really good start with the internet. Do you know what I mean? I think everyone can get a really good start with the internet. So next.
She said that they're making progress with that and basic manners.
Awesome.
And with your help, have convinced her husband that e-collars are not inhumane and have mini educator on the way.
Awesome.
Shayna, I have picked out puppies for several people and I highly recommend the Voldhart puppy test.
Thank you.
Made some awesome matches. Everyone is happy.
Shayna, thank you for mentioning that. I rarely mention names, but yes, I've heard really good, great things about them. I've never personally done it. That's not what I want to be doing, is picking out puppies. So, but I have heard lots of good things from a lot of folks that I respect in the industry. So I don't know Shayna, but she's matching her opinion with the rest of the people that I do respect. So thank you very much for the Voldhart puppy test. Thank you.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. How do I get Kona into follow mode?
Do my 180 move. Go into my search box of my YouTube video, 180. Also, the dog gets a little bit ahead of you. Do a heel tap to the chest. Next.
That was like a solid sound you just made there. Did that hurt you?
No. Fuck that no. Was... I'm fucking working out now.
Top chat.
$4.99. The show answer was worth $5. What if we just have to... Actually... $5, we can get between 3 and 5 at the Providence Oyster Company. I can only get 4. They charge tax on prepared food. I can get 4 oysters. Next.
Deborah, don't yell at me. He's probably going to yell at you, Deborah. My red heeler that's intact is starting to roam. He had a bad experience on the chain as a pup. I've 7.5 acres. He's always running. How do I keep him home?
Deborah, I don't give a shit that your dog was on a chain. That doesn't mean that you have got to give your dog how many acres? 7.5 acres. Maybe you can give your dog now 30 feet of leash while you're holding on to it. So what you can do is you can set up underground fencing. You can remote collar train your dog for recall, but you've got an intact male. I'm a huge fan of spay and neuter, but I'm not one of those like you have to spay and neuter your dog. I own an intact female. My next male, I mean, I actually got one, but he was already, my next male that I get will probably be intact and I'll probably keep him intact. All right. And it's like, and I don't believe all the bullshit that, oh, it prevents all this stuff. It's like, no, the food you're putting in your dog is what's causing all the cancers, not the fucking testicles. All right. Mm-hmm. Look at all these dogs dying of cancer and they have no testicles. Like that didn't fucking work. So what I want you to do is freedom does not equal love. Deborah, freedom does not equal love. Next.
Angela, hold your dog accountable. Boom. There's another mug slogan for you.
There you go.
Reg Bell, I seen you use a slip lead in your video when training place. Should I leave a slip lead on my dog while training inside of the house? He also donated 99 cents.
Bingo. There you go.
Mm-hmm. The life of REI. Thank you. Seriously. Sorry I sent so many questions. This is my first live I've ever been to on your channel, and I'm loving it.
You're still here? Thank you so much.
You didn't scare him away.
You should go to my Patreon channel, patreon.com/solidcaninetraining. patreon.com/solidcaninetraining. Mm-hmm. I answer questions in depth there, next in video format, actually. I literally answer people's questions in long video format. Next.
Greg donated $2 and said, don't blow the damn dog. Love the show. There's a slogan for you.
Shit, is that how I have to raise money? See that? I make 12-year-old jokes. Ha-ha.
Ha-ha.
Okay?
Don't encourage this behavior.
See that?
The lack of no is yes. Okay?
I'm making cash over here, and you're freaking yelling at me.
All right. Looks. I don't know where we are. Doug, have RR male and female RR.
Yep.
When I let them run outside, they get along great. When in the house, there is tension from the female apart in the house since she attacked him 5 weeks ago in the house.
Yeah. So, Doug, it's very, very common. And the reason is because I'm telling you, outside life is different. Dogs can outside off leash, dogs have freedom of movement. They have freedom of movement. They can, they're more in tune to nature. They can pick up each other's signals. They can avoid each other if they have to. They can do the graceful dance if they need to be. They can move out of each other's way. It's almost unlimited space, even in a fenced-in yard. When they're inside, they feel more trapped. They feel more vulnerable inside. They feel more vulnerable inside. So what you need to do is your female. There's tension from the female. The female, now, is the female has tension because the male is the one that starts the fight, or is the female loading and she wants to start the fight and that's the tension you're seeing? I don't know. I'm not there. We'd have to do a consulting thing on that to figure it out. But the best thing you can do for right now is keep them apart. That's not the answer, but you're doing it. If they are bomb-proof outside, let them run around outside, inside the house, put them on separate plates, place commands, crate them separately, and then at least you won't have any fights. You can still have them active, and you don't have to rehome a dog for now. And then the next step would be is obviously I'm available. I mean, I actually make a living getting paid for this stuff. And by the way, when you hire me, it's not all this nonsense. It's if anyone's ever done a Skype with me before, it's freaking really, really serious. Next.
Sure is.
Yep.
Greg says, laugh my ass off.
Thank you.
Angela, LOL, my son walked into the room while you were swearing. He nonchalantly said, he has issues.
Angela, you've got a really, what's the word, perceptive? Receptive?
Receptive.
You have a really smart son. Next. Chef Maga has a glass of wine and a cigar.
Cigar.
That's a cigar.
According to my emojis, that's a cigarette. Okay. I'm on an iPhone, though, so. Buell, hey guys, are there any alternative tools other than prong and e-collars? These tools aren't available here.
Yeah, you can get them. Like, because I train in countries where they're illegal, and I got them, and my clients have them. Just to let you know, I'm not going to tell you to break the law, but even in Germany, where if you're caught, it's a 10,000. What do they do? They're on the euro fine. So no, they weren't on the euro. They were on the they weren't on the mark back then either. What were they on when last time I was there? But you can use a bonker. Any punisher, use a bonker. No. Boom. Bonker is powerful. It's a wrapped up towel. They can't outlaw these. All right? Or else everyone would be walking around wet. Next.
Angela says, my son is 10. Raquel says, I want a mug with your old saying, madly in love with
that's
you.
That's on the
thank
list.
Thank you.
That's the t-shirt. That's the mug.
That's going to be
guys,
a
we're coming
one.
Out with a whole line of t-shirts and mugs.
Excuse me?
Nothing.
I've worked on it more than you.
As you're supposed to be. That's your job. I come up with ideas. You create them.
It's in the works, everyone.
Thank you.
Ice-ski Big Sky. FYI, Joel, men never grow up. Everything is sexual or it's food related. LOL, just go with it. Trust me. And that's why I'm getting divorced.
Okay.
They never grow up. It's true.
But just to let you know, other than this show, I'm not like this.
No, he's not.
Okay? I'm not like this at all. So I actually take offense to your comments. Next.
Jorge, I did not expect to make you laugh with my question, but you make me laugh more with your answer. Thanks for being so frank.
What was the question?
I don't remember.
Oh, good. Jorge, glad you liked it.
Didn't scare him away. Jamal, super effing real stuffed dogs.
Yeah, I know. Yep.
Chevy, I noticed that I've never come across a positive only trainer that does board and trains or that actually takes the leash from the owner. Have you? Gonna write an article about it.
Yeah, I mean, yes, there are some I know, but they don't work with challenging dogs. Okay. The business model is this. Guys, if you go to the, if you want to have some fun, but you have to have a, if you, there's a couple of things. If you go to a positive only seminar, a convention, like, there's a convention out in California that's positive only, and it's a 2-3-4 day seminar. It's a couple of things. Number one, you get to learn, you get to really work on your patient skills. Like really sit through one of their seminars, one of their 1 hour lectures without having to walk out, and you'll really trust your patient skills because you'll realize how bullshit it all is. And guys, let's please remember, when we train obedience, we use reward-based training. That's how we get dogs to do all the obedience commands. Okay? Brittany does trick training. Same thing. Odor work. Same thing. The beginning stages of bite work. Same thing. We reward dogs. We use clickers. We use the marker word yes. We use tons of food. We use high value food. We use physical touch. We use praise. We know how to train dogs, how to do stuff. But that's not what most of these conversations are. How do you get a dog to stop doing something? You obviously can't use a reward, or that you that, or by nature, they would do more of it. It's common sense. So for all the people out there that are touting that they use science, they're lying to you. No, they're not. They're actually lying to you. Reward-based training teaches something new or increases the chance of it happening again, or rewards the dog for doing something you wanted. So when the dog jumps up, you can't use it for stopping jumping. You have to punish the act of jumping. It's really important that people understand that we dabble in both worlds. But a positive trainer does not correct dogs. Therefore, they cannot stop unwanted behaviors. They say they can. So when you go to the seminars, they specifically teach only take easy dogs. They teach that. Literally, why are all these people that are having all these reactive rover classes, they call it anything with all these acronyms or cute voices, stay away from. It's called fucking dog training. That's what it's called. Dog training. Do you work with my reactive dog? Of course we do. We're dog trainers. Oh, we have a reactive rover class. You do? Great. All I know is this. All my clients that went to the reactive rover class were kicked out. Why? They had a reactive dog. What? I thought I signed up for the reactive rover class. So who exactly is allowed to be in there here? Oh, your dog's too reactive. Too reactive? Oh, maybe you should have put that in there. Like small, like minimal reactive rover class, little reactive rover class, and then shrunk the price down to like a nickel, because that's about all it's worth. But then you go to one class of a balanced trainer, and they make more progress than the other one does in 8 to 10 to 36 classes, which one of our clients went to. 36 classes. No progress. Stick with it. Stick with it. Oh, by the way, you have to pay for another 5 classes. Stick with it. Stick up, oh, by the way, you have to pay for another 10 classes. You see what's going on here? Their suckiness costs you constant cash flow. So, next.
Katie Cat, you laugh about the stuffed dog, but my staffie lost her shit on a stuffed animal to the point of snapping her flat buckle collar. It was not a proud moment. LOL.
Go to a positive trainer. They'll fix it. Next.
Greg says, perfect if everyone else owned a stuffed dog. Russ says, I'd love to see that. Go for it. We'll start a trend. Are you going to post it?
What?
Your bar mitzvah picture.
Sure.
Okay. Gal Jez, my dog goes to place every time with no problem, but he won't stay once I'm not next to him. I used leash to get him back before, and today for the first time, I used e-collar. Once he got up, he just jumped back on.
Huh. What do you know? Next.
Gabriel, Jeff, when you first got text, he was challenged. Was he challenging to blend into your pack?
No, I get dogs together a little bit differently than I would recommend an owner to get together. So we had no problem getting together. Next. This is how I introduced text to my dogs, my two main dogs. I put them in the back of my SUV together. That's what I did. And I was there. I didn't close the door and hope for the best. I'm not like these putting dogs in trunks and then whoever's strong survive. But I'm like, I know my dogs well. And Tex had, we had to figure it all out. So I'm like, let's go load up. Tex went in the back of my truck and I stood there and I waited. And if it was going to be nonsense, let there be nonsense on day one. If there's going to be a problem, let's straighten it out right now. I can't have dangerous dogs living in my home. I can't have my dogs being dangerous around each other. So I do things a little bit differently, but I also have a skill set and I don't encourage anybody to do that. Next.
Oh, it was the other half of Gal Jez's question. So he says he just jumped on the sofa, looked all scared, and refused to go to place afterwards.
Well, then you fucked
up. That changes it.
So, Gal Jez, you fucked up, okay? So what you did was that's else what could happen, which it did. The remote collar is not directional. You still have to tell the dog what to do. Have you trained that dog how to go to place on the remote collar? If you haven't trained the dog how to go to place on the remote collar, then you shouldn't be correcting the dog on the remote collar, because the remote collar doesn't make the dog do anything other than jump on a sofa, run away, hide underneath the couch. It's not directional. So you have to teach the dog what it means. Next.
Taryn, how do you e-collar train use e-collar for multiple dogs? Can't imagine carrying more than one at a time and getting it right. Perfect each one first, then don't use. Obsessively watch you now.
No, they make a four-dog remote collar. Next.
Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. What's a heel tap?
Heel tap is imagine you're walking next to your dog. I walk dogs on the left. So if I'm walking one dog, it's on the left. And I'm using my left leg. And you lift up your left leg. And the left heel just taps, like Lily, just tap it backwards. Like you kick a locker, but you're not kicking it hard. But it's a dog. This is a very strong part of a dog. Okay, next.
Dana Walters. Hey, Jeff, back from date night. Just confirming that when you said pre-walk correction means bonk at threshold before walk.
Speaking of bonking, how was the date, Dana?
Oh, my God.
And why are you on my fucking show? Because the date shouldn't be over, Dana. Your date should still be going on.
Dog training is more important.
Okay. Yes, that's what I meant. Now, turn the damn show off and get bonking.
Yes. 1 hour and 22 minutes. Okay. David Smith. So refreshing. When I started to learn dog training back in 98, I read an old book from 41. Balance was all they did then. None of this bullshit today. You rock.
And you know what? It worked. It worked up until the 1970s when they were like, oh, this is how we train dolphins. And we're like, good for you. But I got a dog and it doesn't fucking live in a goddamn isolation tank. And I don't starve it all day until it fucking does fancy tricks for me. This is like a dog. And none of that shit works. All these people that are comparing, like, oh, we do this with whales and penguins and dolphins. I'm like, no, you do it with captured animals that you're starving. I'm sorry. Argue all you want, but that's the fucking game. That's the game. And they do use punishment because they use isolation. They use a lot of punishment. They isolate the animals from other animals. The ultimate punishment for a lot of these animals to a very small area. So Don't let anybody go down that freaking road. And all these people out there, they like to spout, well, they do this in zoos. Do you mean in one millionth of the animal's habitat? Yeah. That's because they're probably semi-intelligent and they want to eat today. Next.
Carol, first time puppy saw snow today. Total confusion at potty time.
Yeah, I know. That's right.
Oh, that's make sure they the don't best, though.
Just make sure that nothing personal goes up against the metal pole.
Mm-hmm.
Next.
Katie Cat, Chevy, my positive only trainers never once took the leash, even when my out of control dog, obsessed dog.
Yep.
Okay. Kaylee J, my cat went to sniff a food wrapper and without thinking, I told her out. Don't think that'll have the same effect on her as it does my dog.
But Kaylee, if you throw a bonker at the cat, it will. Mm-hmm. And I'm being serious. Next.
Shayna, piece of advice about doing Volhart tests. Some breeders get intimidated by Bayer in the KNW, so they
don't. In the know, yeah.
Oh, in the know. So they don't like it when you tell them you want to test the puppy. If this happens to you, don't do business with them.
Shayna, you're full of tips.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, look at you.
Good to know. Blue on Black, was interesting what you said about intact dogs. In your experience, do other dogs who have been neutered react more to unneutered dogs, or is that an excuse people use for their dog's bad behavior?
Okay. 99% of the dogs that we rehabilitate come to us with massive anxiety, massive human aggression, massive dog aggression, name every bad behavior there is existent to humankind. And 99% of them have been de-sexed. So the act of removing a reproductive system didn't fix the problem, number one. The dogs that we have, and knowing that these dogs are de-sexed, the dogs that are aggressive towards other dogs will try to get into a fight with our staff dogs because that's who we use to help rehab them. And most of our staff dogs have been de-sexed. So I believe that aggression with a dog, it's not testicle-based, meaning whether you have them or whether you're targeting them. I believe that it's unwanted behavior, and that's what it is. So, and I'd like to really, really focus on that because I don't like people making any excuse to why their dog is aggressive other than because we haven't stopped it yet. And that's the reason why. Next.
Chevy, so are you into girls now, Joelle? What would give you that idea?
Chevy, this is a professional show, okay? I know you New Zealanders are a little bit freewheeling over there, but come on. This is no.
Dipper Maybell Stan, greetings from Peru.
Hey, Peru, how are you?
Taryn, oh crap, I'm going to reactive rover class tomorrow morning, LOL.
Okay, have fun.
I Ski Big Sky, that was our first fight, Jeff. I was just teasing. I've watched a ton of your vids. I know you are serious when it comes to training. That's why I'm here. So thanks for all you do to help people.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
When is there a discrepancy?
What do you mean? Was that our first fight? I don't know. I mean, if you're flirting with me, what happened? Do you want makeup sex already? I mean, what happened?
Better get your ass to Montana.
I know. Check the air first. Get down to Expedia right now. What's the biggest city there?
No idea. Lorena. Agreed, Jeff. My snowflake vet sentenced my dog to death. He's reactive, fearful chow who got that way because I read bad ideas. Trusted the vet. Then as soon as he heard that bark, he abandoned the dog.
You're a fucking pussy. Yeah. I can't stand freaking spineless dog trainers. Next.
Angela, I've always wondered what the difference is between a dog trainer and a dog behaviorist.
Well, in the UK, a behaviorist could be a trainer. In the United States, theoretically, a behaviorist is supposed to be somebody with a medical degree, but it could be a trainer just trying to sound smart. Do you know what I mean? So, you know, they have animal behaviorists, which are usually have gone through their vet recommended. But the bottom line is, like, show me your videos of your work. grab the leash, show me what you can do. I don't give a shit what you freaking wrote about. I don't care what you spout. Like, I mean, here I am spouting, but also give me the damn leash. I'll show you. That's why I tour the world doing seminars. I practice what I preach. I'm not some just guy sitting behind a microphone yelling and screaming. I mean, I'm you know, in the trenches with the rest of you doing the hard work. So, you know, but over in the UK, they use the word behaviorist differently than they use it over here in the US. Next.
Lorena says, easy, happy-go-lucky dogs only.
Yep.
Shana, Jeff, it means a lot to me that you gave me props for knowing the Volhart test. Thank you so much. When I see you at T3 in Rhode Island, I would love to share more info with you if you are okay with that.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, if we've got time. T3 is weird because it's you're exhausted, I'm exhausted. At the end of the day, you're going out with all the attendees at lunch. Myself, Sean, and Tori, we go back into our little cave to eat lunch to like wind down. But yeah, I mean, you don't have to wait till T3. Just send me shit now. Next.
Cotton Flower 2, best way to get a 5-month-old puppy to stop barking at noises?
I mean, get a bark collar. That makes it simple. Just get a bark collar or get a bonker, but make a bonker. I just did a video on making a bonker and just, you know, just say no and throw it at the dog. I always say no first. Next.
Gal Jez says, okay, thanks. Shana, why do you always say never let dogs meet for the first time while on leash?
Well, actually, I say never let them meet at all on a leash. A leash is a barrier. A leash is a barrier. A leash agitates dogs. When a dog gets to the end of the leash, and if it's on, say, a flat buckle collar, a martingale, or on a harness, and it starts pulling, it starts going into drive, and it can start getting agitated and frustrated. And you don't get natural behavior out of the dog. Like that's how the foundational work of bite work starts. Just think about it that way. The foundational work of bite work starts by having a dog pull on a leash. Just think about it that way. Next. Oh my God, it's late.
Yep.
We got to end the show.
Yep. I'm 30.
Two more questions.
Okay. Scandalisa. I was trying to find the working level for my dog, and I got up to 31 before I saw any reaction.
Check fit. It's probably bad fit. Next.
Cottonflower 2, I've seen one or some of your videos where you were able to train a highly reactive dog to walk nicely in one session. How?
Yeah, I do it every day. It's easy to do. Once you understand how to properly apply, guys, just sometimes switching out equipment is all you need. So switching out equipment and understanding and having basic leash handling skills is usually all you need. But then also understanding how to stop arousal in 1 second helps. And then understanding how to apply proper punishment helps. But most good dog trainers can take the most highly reactive dogs, and in one session, at least there is a resemblance of normalcy. I mean, almost all my colleagues should be able to do it because it's not that difficult to do. Unless you have learned how to properly apply punishment in your training protocols, you'll never be able to stop unwanted behavior and you will be struggling for years. And I don't want people to be struggling for years. That's why I yell and scream so much. It's not because of the dogs. It's because of the people. You guys are struggling. You guys are suffering. You guys are getting bit. You're getting dragged around. Like, people are getting injured. The hell with dog bites? People are being knocked down, pulled down, dragged. I would love to know if there was a study out there on emergency room visits turned into dollars on dog injuries inflicted on a human that were not bite related. So not the bites. Take the bites away, all other injuries, a dog running into them and knocking them over, being pulled over by a dog, having the dog pull you and trip. We're talking about concussions, broken bones, dislocated shoulders, strained ligaments, twisted ankles. And then what I'd like to know is how much income revenue was lost because the person couldn't work. So what's the medical bills? What's the rehab bills? How much loss of wages were there? Okay. I would love to know what that number was from non-biting dogs. So I've been mauled a couple of times early in my career. I was back in work in a couple of days. Do you know what I mean? I mean, it's just a bite. It was a bunch of bites, but I was able to function. I mean, I was in massive amounts of pain, but I was able to function. Your average dog bite, you can still like go to work in 1 day or 2 days. I've been to work the same day before. I got bit in the morning. It was bad enough. Half the time when I used to get bit a lot. Why? My ego was humongous. My skill set sucked, and I was working dogs above my skill set, way above my skill set. So I got bit. So, but I barely ever like just give me some hydrogen peroxide and some lotion, whatever shit, and bandage, and boom, go back to work. I don't care. That's why I've got scars all over my body. But now we're not getting bit at all. But your average dog owner, though, like you break something or twist something, you ought to work for a while. I wouldn't be surprised if it was 100-1 compared to dog bites. Everyone's worried about dog bites. Pulling dogs are way more dangerous than a dog bite. So that woman that has a 10-month-old St. Bernard, that dog is way more dangerous than a biting dog for her. That's why she's got to find help. So we got to go, guys. I'm, you know, curfew's at 9:30. Plus, she's got to get to sleep because I'll be knocking on her window at 6 in the morning.
Wake up. 5:30. I will be up.
We'll see. Join us tomorrow morning for our walk. All right. All right, guys. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Joelle sitting in doing the show. The next show is on Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The replays of these shows are available in a day or two. You can also listen to the show on SoundCloud, on Spotify, on iTunes, on iHeartRadio, on Google, and a couple of other different sound platforms. If you don't know us on Instagram, go to our website, Solid Canine Training, and just start clicking and joining our Facebook, our YouTube, our Instagram channels. We put different content up on each channel. All right. A lot of fun stuff, a lot of educational stuff out there as well. If you're struggling with your dog, you don't need to. You honestly don't need to. All right. You can stop. You can stop today. Literally today. Tomorrow you can have the best walk of your life. Okay. All right, guys. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for listening to all my nonsense. Thank you for putting up with me. And I really, really appreciate it. Take care, everybody. Bye.